making Thanksgiving feast for the duckies. Now, I'm no Rachel Ray, but this isn't even going to take me 30 minutes. These are called tomatoes. We have some peas here. They're soaking now because they were frozen. So they're a little bit, I need to warm those up. We're going to cut up two tomatoes to start. Like top chef. Now we'll check the peas that are soaking on the back burner. Yeah, we're gonna dump those out again. Those are looking good, but we'll make sure they're completely thawed by running some more warm water over them. I don't know if you can see that. Those are store-bought bagged frozen peas of the generic Safeway variety. All right, we're back now. We're just about to bust out the fine china. This is, it's Dixie brand. I'm not sure where you can get this pattern of china. But I don't think it's exclusive, so I'm sure you can find something similar in your own area. This, we're going to bust out the oyster shell. That is a fine grade of farm supply oyster shell. Perfect for ducks who are laying eggs right now and need that extra calcium. So that's going to be Georgie's treat and Feed K's treat. She's also laying eggs right now. So with that, we've got your oyster shell. Let's recap. Got your oyster shell, you have your broken up lettuce, romaine lettuce, your diced tomatoes, we're gonna put that out on a nice plate, and we unfroze those peas that were sitting here on the back burner, and those are going out. And I believe that is the perfect group of treats for a Thanksgiving dinner for the ducks. So with that, we're gonna put those out, we're gonna invite them in and see how this goes.
There's traffic in the sky and it doesn't seem to be getting much better. There's kids playing games on the pavement, drawing waves on the pavement. Mm-hmm. Shadows of the planes on the pavement. Mm-hmm. It's enough to make me cry, but that don't seem like it will make me feel better. Maybe it's a dream, and if I scream, it will burst at the seams. The whole place would fall into pieces, and then it seems. Well, how could we have known? I'll tell them it's not so hard to tell. Nah, nah. You keep that a stone, you soon the water away. You lost in the well. Pieces in the ground, no one ever seems to be digging. Instead they're looking up towards the heavens with their eyes on the heavens. The shadows on the way to the heavens. It's enough to make me cry, that don't seem like it will make you feel better. The answers could be found, we could love from digging down. But no one ever seems to be digging, instead they'll say. Well, how could we have known? I'll tell them it's not so hard to tell. Nah, nah. You keep that a stone, soon the water will be lost in the well. Mm-hmm. Words of wisdom all away, but no one ever seems to listen. They're talking about the plans on the paper, building up from the pavement. Shadows from the scrapers on the pavement. It's enough to make me sigh. That don't seem like it will make me feel better. The words are all around, but the words are only sound. No one ever seems to listen. Instead, they'll sing. Well, how could we have known? I'll tell them it's really not so hard to tell. No, no. You keep that in stone, so the water will be lost in the well, lost in the well.
There's a lovable love, you know that. Turn to the inevitable. Want some peace?
I could have been a sailor, I could have been a cook.
Happy Thanksgiving,
brother. Well, I have love. Simple as a kettle, steady as a rock. I could be here and now. I would be, I should be, but how? I could have been. I could have been.